Now we are going to start with the first theory that was put forward in order to explain the reason behind the chemical linkage, and that was the Lewis-Kossel theory. Lewis actually gave this theory in 1916. This theory, when this theory was given, the quantum approach was not there. We were just familiar with the Bohr model, right? So I'll just explain what was the Bohr model. Bohr actually stated that, for example, I consider an example of sodium. I have an atomic number 11. He said, it has an atomic number 11. We know that its mass number is 23. So he said that there is a nucleus, and in nucleus there are protons and neutrons. So let us write that how many protons and neutrons. There are shells around orbit or the energy levels, right? And we are going to distribute the number of electrons here. So let us say 2 electrons, 8 electrons, and 1 electron. So this was the Bohr model actually. So he just stated that what is the reason behind that, an atom cannot exist independently, it has to link with some other atom. So what he did, in order to explain that, he considered this nucleus and these inner shell electrons, because these are inner shells, as it has three shells, right, K, L, M, and in first shell there are 2 electrons, in second there is 1, in third there is 1, 8 and the 1. So that means they are going to form inner shell electrons. So he said that the nucleus and plus inner shell electrons, they form a kernel. They form a positively charged kernel, and except that what we have is an outermost shell. What we have is an outermost shell. So this is our outermost shell. So he said that we can divide the atom into two portions. That is, one is the nucleus and the inner electrons, and apart from that, what we have is the outer shell. And he said that the outer shell can accommodate the maximum of electron, that is the 8 electrons. So how he explained that it has the outermost shell is going to have 8 electrons. For that explanation, he just explained everything by drawing a cube. He said that suppose we have a cube, right? In this is a kernel. That means the nucleus and the inner electrons. That means the nucleus and the inner shell electrons. So he said, as the cube has 8 corners, so that means maximum of electron that an outermost shell can have is equal to the number of the corners of the cube. So that means how many electrons corners you can get to see in a cube? Obviously 8 corners. So how many electrons can an atom have? So he said that the outermost shell of an atom can have the maximum of the electrons, which is equal to the number of the corners in the cube. So that means it can possess only 8 electrons. So this is what I have shown you. Then he said, in 8 electrons, they are arranged at each corner of the cube. And where is the kernel? Kernel occupies the central position. This is what I told you. Then he said that the octet of electrons, that means having an 8 electrons in outermost shell, it represents the stable electronic arrangement. As you can see that he said that all the corners are filled with electrons, that means the structure is going to have a stable arrangement. Stable arrangement means stable electronic conformation. So he said, in order to attain stability, what do we want to have? We need to achieve the octet. We need to achieve the octet. What is that? Octet means tendency to attain. Octet is tendency to attain 8 electron in outermost shell of an atom. So he said that this is the reason that one needs to combine, because if I say that it is sodium, so obviously if I draw this cube for the sodium, we are not going to have electron at each corner because it has only 1 electron, so obviously we are going to have only 1 electron. So that means it is somehow not stable, right? So that means he said that that is the reason that it needs to combine, because it needs to attain an 8 electron in the outermost shell of an atom. So this is what he said, that there is the reason behind the combination is the octet rule. And what is that octet rule? Tendency to attain 8 electron in the outermost shell. And he said that in order to achieve the octet, this is the reason why the atoms are linking with the another atoms in order to form a molecule. And the reason behind is that they need to get stable, as everything in the universe is just running behind stability, you know that, right? So in order to attain stability, what they are doing here, they just need to have an octet, and to for completing an octet, they need to combine with some other atom. So he said that this is the reason that why the atoms are looking for the link linkage, or this is the reason why they are linking up, because like when they link up, they just you can say this thing, they are just completing their octet, and the time they complete their octet, they achieve the stability. Now the reason, the methods by which they can complete their octet is that either they can do it by sharing of electrons, or they can do it by transfer of electrons. So that means they can complete their octet by using two methods, by two techniques. Either they can share electrons or they can transfer electrons. So like if they share electrons, then also they can complete their octet, and sometimes they transfer electron. That means the one atom gives the electron, other accept the electron. So likewise, by transfer of electrons also, they can just complete their octet. And you know that the chemical bond which is formed by sharing of electron is a covalent bond. So here we classify the chemical bond into two categories. One which is formed by sharing of electron is a covalent bond, and which the transfer of electron is going to take place is an ionic bond. And the other name is electrovalent bond. So that means we know that according to Lewis, that the reason behind the linkage is the octet, and depending upon that we are just looking for the completion of octet now. So we can do it by sharing of electrons, and as a result the bond form is called as covalent bond, or either we can do it by shuffling of electrons, that means transferring of electrons, that is called as something ionic bond. Or we can use the term electrovalent bond. So this was clear, according to Lewis, it was clear that the reason behind the linkage is just to complete the octet, right? So, and depending upon that, every atom, like according to Lewis, it is just assumed that every atom is just looking to complete its octet. And how it is completing? Either by sharing an electrons with another atom, or by transferring of electrons. Now we'll just look up that how we can form a covalent bond, or how we can form the ionic bond.